Now, starting with the road user characteristic studies. As I said, it is all about us. So, this road user characteristic study is further divided into four subcategories. One is physical road user characteristics. Second one is mental road user characteristics. Third one is psychological road user characteristics. And the last one is environmental road user characteristics. So, we are starting with physical road user characteristics. So, there are two types of physical road user characteristics. One can be categorized as temporary, the other ones are permanent ones. Okay. So, in the temporary category, the factors like illness, drug abuses and alcoholism comes. So these are the factors which reduces our efficiency, right? So what it actually does is it reduces our alertness, which increases our reaction time, and sometime it also affects the quality of our judgments. So these temporary factors are not good for us. Now coming to the permanent physical characteristics, these are our vision, hearing, strength and general reaction. So these are our permanent physical characteristics. Now coming to the point general reaction, there is a theory which is PIF theory. This theory is being used to calculate the general reaction or reaction time of any driver. So the initials of PIF theory stands for some words. Okay, so let's know what are those. So P stands for perception, I stands for intellection, E stands for emotion, and V for volition. So this makes the PIF theory. Now coming in more details, let us assume a car is moving through a road and suddenly the driver sees an obstacle on the road. Now the moment when the driver sees the obstacle, he will need some time to react and to apply the brake, and after application of brake the car will be stopped. So the in between moment when the driver see the obstacle and when the driver apply the brake, that is called as reaction time, and the distance covered by the car in the reaction time is called as lag distance. And when the car is moving after application of brake till it gets stopped is known as braking distance, and the time can be called as braking duration. So we will focus on the reaction time. Okay, so how the PIF theory justifies the reaction time? Okay, so what are the processes what are the reasons behind the reaction times? Okay, so let us assume this is the brain of the driver. Okay, so let us assume this is the brain of the driver, and when the driver sees the obstacle, some impulses will be transmitted into his brain. So this is the perception of the driver. Now after the information received by the brain, the driver will think that what he needs to do. He can stop the car or he can slow down the car, right? So that is intellection of the driver. So there is another factor comes, that is emotion of the driver. which can be fear of the driver, which can be some superstitious beliefs of the driver. So that will consume some time. And after that, after taking the decision, the brain will send the signal to some body parts to apply the brake. So this process is known as volition. So the volition, because of the volition, the response will be occurred. Okay, that is the application of the brake. So why these processes happen? Because of the reflex action of the driver. So PIP theory justifies the reaction time properly. Now, as per IRC guidelines, we will take the reaction time as 2.5 seconds while designing. Now, the other factors are mental factors, psychological factors, and environmental factors. Okay. So, these are the other road user characteristics factors. So, in mental factors, what are the sub factors? Those are knowledge, experience, skill, and literacy of driver and pedestrians. Okay. And in psychological field, attentiveness, fear, superstitious impatience, and anger of the persons comes. Okay. And in environmental road user characteristics factors, factors like roadside features, atmospheric condition, and locality matters most. So this is the end of the road user characteristics.